About 1,500 years ago, in the mountains to the northwest of Mount A Castle in the air appeared, suspended abruptly from the cliff. It is called Xuankong Temple. Speaking of Xuankong Temple, many people may not be familiar with it. Literally, a temple suspended in the air, yes. But many have doubts. How can it hang in the air? Actually, Xuankong Temple. Generally speaking, it is the ancient times. Buildings such as temples or palaces built on the cliffs. It is a collection of aesthetics, mechanics, architecture, religion and so on as one. It is a treasure of Chinese ancient architecture and even world architecture. The name of Xuankong Temple can be found in as many as 7 places in China. There are 5 in the north of Shanxi Hengshan Xuankong Temple. Hebei Canyon Mountain Xuankong Temple, Henan Kuixi and Chang'an Xuankong Temple. Xuankong Temple in Xining, Qinghai Province. There are 2 in the south. Xuankong Temple in Xishan, Yunnan Province, and Xuankong Temple in Dacian, Jiandai, Zhejiang Province. To say the most famous, large-scale, sophisticated architecture. The influence is extensive, want to number Shanxi Hengshan Xuankong Temple. Xuankong Temple is located at the foot of Hengshan Mountain in Shanxi Province. Hunyuan County 5 kilometers south of the Jinglong Valley. Back to Qubing Mountain, facing Tian Fengling, on the cliff. There is a deep valley below, about 50 meters above the ground. It's like sticking to a cliff. The whole temple, there are more than 40 pavilions. Temple for the west, temple gate facing south, pavilions facing east. The temple is high in the north and low in the south. The 3 layers are stacked as if supported by only a dozen slender wooden pillars. Very breathtaking, known as the temple. Half a day high, 3 horsemen tail hanging in the air. In the architectural layout, there is a monastery at the south end. At the north end, there are 2 overhanging flying towers. Although high in the air, it still follows the traditional layout of the temple. Hill gate, bell and drum tower, hall and a lot of side hall. It ingeniously combines the planar architecture of the general monastery. Used in the spatial plane of a solid. It embodies the superb wisdom of craftsmen in ancient China. Xuankong Temple was built in the late Northern Wei Dynasty. It has a history of more than 1,500 years. Xuankong Temple has been renovated throughout the ages. It is the earliest preserved time in our country. The most complete preservation of high, altitude wooden structure cliff building. It also has a unique feature. It integrates the 3 cultures of Taoism, Buddhism, and Confucianism. It is the only ancient building in China with 3 religions in one. In 1982, it was published by the state as the first batch of state key cultural relics protection units. Why did the ancient people build the temple on the cliff? The question can only be imagined now. A more plausible explanation is that Xuankong Temple is located in heavy rain, the lower part is easy to be flooded. So people want to build on top. The cliff where the temple is located is a small concave surface. The high cliff overhangs the temple complex like an umbrella to protect it from heavy rain. This is not a coincidence, it should be the ancients after strict site selection. How can a temple be suspended in the air? Many of you might think. It may have been the upright columns that supported it. Not really. First of all, the pillars are made of wood. I don't know if I can bear such heavy pressure. It's also perishable, which is bad for preservation. And the pillars were not known to have existed before. It was added by later generations for fear of the collapse of the temple. It doesn't really work, right? What really works is the beam that lies across the cliff. The beams are made of wood over 50 centimeters in diameter, embedded in the cliff. The wood is made from local hemlock trees soaked in tung oil. It is preservative and extremely hard. Xuankong Temple used it cleverly. Set its center of gravity on hard rock within the cliff. That's what's called a semi-inserted beam base. The insertion of the beam was also designed, according to expert estimates. It's similar to an expansion bolt. A wedge was added to the side of the rock. As the beam gets deeper and deeper, it expands. It fits perfectly with the cave. So here's the problem. The cliff is 2/3 of the length of the wood. How did the ancients get into such a deep hole? Why did the temple survive for so long? The mountains here are like a hanging pot. The center was sunken in, and the temple was built at the bottom of the pot. In other words, the wind can't blow, the rain can't rain. Out of reach of the sun. With the addition of repairs from various dynasties, it has been preserved. Xuankong Temple is about 60 meters above the ground. The highest Sanjiao Temple is 90 meters above the ground. Due to years of riverbed siltation, now only 58 meters. Xuankong Temple has developed China's architectural tradition and style. The whole temple is perilously close to the ravine. Back rock by niche, temple gate to the south, the west is positive. The whole temple is a wooden frame structure. According to the principle of mechanics, the half-inserted beam is the base, conveniently borrowed from the rock. Beam column up and down a body, the corridor column left and right tightly connected. Its architectural features can be summarized wonder, hang, chow three words. Qi, looking at Xuankong Temple. Like an exquisite relief. Mosaic in the precipitous cliff, close to see the hanging temple. It's about to fly. Hung, the temple has a total of 40 temple. They appear to be supported by more than a dozen bowl, thick wooden posts. In fact, some of the posts are not stressed at all. It is said that when the temple was built, there were no such stakes. People saw that the temple seemed to have no support. Fear of falling off the temple, in order to reassure the people. So posts were placed at the base of the temple. So someone used the temple of the sky, half a day high, three horsemen tail hanging in the air to describe the temple. Chow, reflected in the construction of the temple in accordance with local conditions. Make full use of the natural arrangement of the cliff. And the construction of the various parts of the temple. The general layout of the temple plain architecture. Form and form are built in three-dimensional space. Hill gate, bell and drum tower, hall, side hall, etc. It's very cleverly designed. Xuankong Temple not only looks breathtaking, strange, spectacular. The architectural structure is also quite distinctive. The form is rich and colorful, eaves have single eaves, double eaves, three layers eaves. The mass structure has girder structure, flat roof structure, dugong structure. The roof has a right ridge, vertical ridge, peak ridge, lean ridge. Overall appearance, clever macro system, overlapping. It creates a kind of cave with a tower in it and a cave in it. Half wall floor and hall, half wall grottos, grottos connected with the hall, hall connected with the unique style of the floor. It not only integrates Chinese garden architecture art. Do not lose the pattern of China's traditional architecture. Xuankong Temple existing in a variety of copper casting, iron casting, clay sculpture. There are many styles in stone carvings. The style has the characteristics of an earlier period. It is a treasure of high artistic value. The dexterity of Xuankong Temple is reflected in its adaptation to local conditions. Make full use of the natural arrangement of the cliff. And the construction of the various parts of the temple. The general layout of the temple plain architecture. Form and form are built in three-dimensional space. Hill gate, bell and drum tower, hall, side hall, etc. The design is very elaborate. There are more than 80 Buddha statues in the temple. Why can the three religions be united here? Since ancient times, various sects have had their own ideas. Therefore, Tianxia Temple Hall is divided. But the temple will be three into a temple, it is rare. As to why there is a trinity here? This is actually a puzzle. More to the point, it was originally a Taoist temple. In order to adhere to the influential Tao Hongjing thought of the unity of the three religions. It is here that a temple of Confucianism, Buddhism and Taoism is formed. It is also because of the Trinity. Later dynasties and successive dynasties to the Temple of the Great Repair and Protection. That's one of the reasons it's preserved for thousands of years. In a word, the essence of this wonderful architecture. There are so many mysteries waiting to be discovered. We should protect it, study it, publicize it. Let the whole world know the wisdom of ancient Chinese architecture. Know the great Chinese culture.